welcome to the FX Delta 2 introduction webinar. In this video, guys, I'm going to show you how you can trade the software completely free and manually. I'll also show you what we did in the second version of the software. Excuse me, what are the changes we did, what kind of features were added, and much more. If you already know how the software works, you can use all these numbers that you see right here and you can jump to the relevant section for you. And if you're looking at this thing for the first time, I advise you to go ahead and watch the entire video because you're going to learn a lot here. All right, we have plenty of work, so let's not waste any more time. Before we go to the actual stuff, again, I would like to remind you here, what I'm going to show you today could be traded completely free by doing it manually. I did that in the first 2 years, I believe, on my own without any software, manually. It's doable, it works. You just need to dedicate a bit more time. That's all. What the software does here is just scan the patterns for you, find divergences, and you know, facilitate everything that we do as traders to a certain extent. Of course, there are things that we do manually, but let's say 90-95% of the job will be done by the software. That doesn't mean you need to get it, right? You could still do it, and I actually encourage you to do it first of all manually, understand the idea of how this pattern works, and only then, if this thing fits your trading style and you like it, you can consider getting the software. Okay, it's much better to start from the bottom and work your way through the top and then get the software, because if you rely to the software immediately, there is a chance you're going to miss some important things which you're going to catch by doing it manually. Okay, now if you don't know who I am, very quick introduction to myself. My name is Yordan Kuzmanov. I'm from Bulgaria, guys. I do have approximately, I don't know how many years is now, let's say around 12 years probably, trading experience. A real trading experience will be between 8, 9 years, 10 years, something like that. I'm talking about the initial stage where, you know, you're just looking at green candles and you're buying. So all that combined, it's a bit more years, but a real trading experience came a bit later. My preferred trading style is mid to short term. I do enjoy occasionally to trade a bit longer term setups if they appear. I'm talking about daily, weekly charts, but in general, I like to swim anywhere between 1 hour to daily. I am definitely a technical analyst. I don't know much about fundamentals. I don't understand much about economics. I just follow the regular basic stuff, which I guess pretty much everyone else is following. So I'm not an expert there by any means. I like the technicals. I do understand them. I've dedicated my time to master this trading method, so I'm sticking with that. Currently, I'm working at the Traders Academy Club as a chief trader. I'm also strategy developer, and for some time now I've started coding, which means I'm slowly entering the world of algorithmic trading, and that's pretty much my short history here. Now this is what we're going to cover today. Excuse me. So again, if you're already familiar with Delta, guys, you can skip these three parts. This is basically going to show us the original idea, the basis, right? So if you're already aware of that, please do skip it and you can go straight to there. So we're going to cover very quickly how was Delta born, what is the actual Delta pattern that we're working with, how you can trade it manually. Then we're going to look at the second version of the software, which was released a week or two ago. We're going to cover some of the new features in the software, and then we're going to see a few examples just to give you an idea how this thing looks and what and how it will benefit you. Excuse me once again. Now, history of Delta is probably not that long, but it's also not that short. It all started approximately 4 years ago when I found this pattern I spotted on the chart, and I started trading it manually. Then a few years later, I've decided to create a software, and you know, just to make my life a bit easier. We later on decided to make it as a commercial product, which means to be sold and people to be actually able to enjoy from that as well. Then Delta 2 came, and we're currently on that stage. Now we're working on a scalping module. There is a question mark there because we really don't know if this thing is going to pass everything that we're doing basically once creating a strategy. So hopefully, I mean, the community definitely has interest in the scalping part, which could be implemented here, but reality is we don't know if this is going to happen or not. It will take time, it will take tests, so fingers crossed. You know, if it happens, we can release it. If it doesn't, we're just going to remove it and that's it. But the idea is that we're looking forward to further improvements, so let's see where that takes us. Speaking about the community, you can see here some feedback, and I've posted this link on purpose. You can check the software reviews on Forex Peace Army. So basically, we're getting pretty much 5 stars here, which is not bad at all. And I don't want for this to sound like, okay, this is perfect, this is the holy grail. I will tell you from now, guys, it will work for some, it will not work for others. Okay, it's not like this is going to work for absolutely everyone. That's why, again, as I said in the beginning of the video, I encourage you to go ahead and use this software, not software, the pattern that I'm going to talk about manually. See how it works, if it fits your style, if you like it or not, and then, and only then, consider the actual software. Okay? It's like cars. I mean, there are plenty of models, plenty of sizes. We cannot have one that fits all, right? Same with trading softwares, trading strategies, and trading methods. So, that being said, we said we have trading community. By trading community, what I mean is that we have a Telegram group dedicated to Forex Delta alone, meaning that you will find many people trading the same software at the same place, sharing ideas, discussing trading setups. And I think this is really crucial when it comes to, especially for new traders, because trading could be a lonely job, especially if you're doing it part-time or you're a retail trader working from home. Majority of the times what we see, including me, I really don't have any friends who are doing that. So having people to talk about trading in general, it's very, you know, it's beneficial psychologically and everything. So at least this part is covered. I mean, if you get the software, you're also getting instant access to this community, so you're not going to be alone by any means. And now let's go ahead and cover where it all started. Since I started trading a bit more serious, meaning that I got some knowledge, I immediately became a huge fan of MACD coming from divergences. And I've been looking at this indicator for many, many, many years, guys, literally many years. And at some point I just showed something which had the potential, right? This is where everything started, okay? And basically what this pattern showed me is that we can be finding very good moments when the market is moving very fast, and usually there is a very nice continuation after this pattern happens. This could be showing us reversals, this could be showing us continuations. I like trading it on the very first time when it happens, meaning the reversal part. So if we get the reversal plus delta pattern, usually we have a much stronger trend coming afterwards. And when we do, now you will see in a few slides how we do it, but once you combine it with the lower time frames, the risk reward ratios for some trades become keyer. Okay, so this is basically how it started. I mean, it was spot there. I started playing with different ratios and different formulas. Of course, it didn't fit on all trading instruments with the same ratios. So this is kind of the proprietary part, which is not going to be shared with you. But in general, if you go back to the charts after you see this presentation, you will see that it pretty much works good. Okay? Because all these things which are put here, right? This pattern is covering them. I don't know why and I don't know how, but it does. So I had the first stage in place, or the first step, and we move on to the next one. Okay, let's say on the first step we have direction. We know that we should be looking for buys. So the second step of this let's say trading method was to find the actual entries. I did try a few things, well, maybe more than a few, I just put here a few. But basically, I did try investment styles, short-term investment styles combined with the 4-hour chart. I did try hedging, I did try Bollinger Bands, I did try a few more type of breakouts, like trendline breakouts. And I mean, I did dedicate some time there, but at the end of the day, there is always something missing, okay? And I don't know how to explain it, guys. I mean, you have to go through the process to understand how it works, but it literally took months and months of trial and testing, because it's not like we have 5-minute and 15-minute chart that you can go ahead and test for 2 months and get enough data, right? Enough sample to make some conclusions. It took some time. And again, there was always something missing, okay? So the moment came, the Eureka moment, as we see it in the presentation, came once I thought to include divergences. So again, as I said in the previous slide, if we already have a direction, why don't we look for pullbacks on the lower time frames and confirm the end of this pullback with divergence? That was it. I mean, I've been doing divergences for ever since I remember myself as a trader, but I'm not sure why this came last as an idea. Doesn't matter, important part is it came to my mind for some reason, and when I applied it, everything started clicking together. So, Now we had it basically. I mean, you have the direction, then you're looking for the pullbacks, and once this pullbacks is finished based on the divergences, we can be looking for the continuation. Okay, because what I was doing previously, as I told you guys, is, let's say I would look for highs to be broken, but I didn't realize, because you know, in general, you know, it's supposed to be pullback, so why not buy every breakout? Well, that's the thing, if you don't have divergence, this move is clearly not finished yet. I mean, there will be situations where it will happen, naturally, but majority of the time you want to confirm the end of the pullback with the divergence, because this is what divergences are giving us, right? The end of a trend or supposedly a possible reversal happening or a pullback happening. So if this is a pullback already and you have the direction from the higher time frame, divergences fit perfectly in such situations. So now we had the full package, we had the direction, we had the entry methods. It was time to start testing it. Again, it took some time to test it, because back then, of course, there was no software to help, not even, like, I'm not talking about fully automation to see the statistics, I'm talking about at least something that gives you when the pattern is there, when the divergence is finished, you know, breakouts are happening, because it's, I don't know, 5 minutes out of 3, 4, 5 days of waiting, and it's very easy to miss it. So that's the part where it was a bit annoying, but at the end of the day, I think it was worth it. Now, that's how things look in theory, guys. Okay, so basically the delta pattern on the higher time frame is giving us the direction. Then we're using divergences on the lower time frames to find, to spot as precisely as possible the end of this pullback with the divergence, and then we're looking for entries. And now let's see what exactly the delta pattern is and how you can use it manually. The delta pattern is entirely based on the MACD indicator. Okay, we're trying to catch there by the ratios that I'm going to show in a second. Volumes and strong trends. That's it. We don't need more. What we are doing is we're measuring the ratio between the histogram to zero and the histogram to the fast MA. I know this might be sounds probably confusing. Bear with me, we're going to cover it in a second. What else we can say is that this is a classical trend following strategy or pattern. We're looking to be trading with the trend. So basically the delta pattern is identifying this move, and then we're looking for the continuation after that move. We're not looking for reversals, we're looking for trend continuation. The MACD indicator, if you're not familiar, looks like this. Basically, we have two histograms. Let's just change the color here. We have the green histogram, we have the red histogram. This is the bars. And basically, this is where the zero level is, right between the two. This is our zero level. We have the moving averages, these two guys here are the lines, and that's all. That's all we need. This indicator you can find for free on the internet, guys. So again, that thing could be traded absolutely manually without any investment. Now let's go ahead and check out what and how a bullish pattern looks like. Inside the presentation, you have all these text and numbers and so on and so forth. But I would like to focus on the image here, because working with the image, you can read on your own time the text. But let me explain to you with a few simple words how it works. So the MAs are breaking the zero level right here. Simultaneously with the MAs, the histogram, ever since it switched here, it's starting to create green bars. And what we're doing is we take the highest part of the MA, the blue MA, and we measure the range before the previous red and before the next red. Basically, we're measuring the green segment right here. Everywhere we have green candles, green histograms. This is the part that we measure. So the highest point of the MAs, right, versus the highest point of the histogram. And then we are measuring the highest point of the histogram versus zero level. So in reality, we're comparing this distance from here to here, which in this case we call X, and we're comparing it to the distance between the top of the histogram versus the top of the MAs versus that distance. That's all. It's that simple. We want to see big ratios right here. Again, for some pairs, for different time frames, it is slightly different. But if you stick to this, let's say 1-to-2 ratio, one here to here, you will get a pretty good idea how this thing works. Okay? That's it. I mean, again, I'm not going to cover the numbers and all this. I just want you to get the basic idea and understanding of how it works. This is where the green histogram starts, so that's the range. This is where the green histogram ends, right here. So that's our range, the horizontal range. We take the highest point, which is right here. We measure it and we call it, let's say, X. And then we take the highest point up to here of the MAs. This is the highest point. And we compare these two zones. All right? That's what we do. And this is where we go. And we know that this is a bullish delta pattern. We're expecting for the price to continue higher. On the other hand, we have the bearish patterns, which are doing pretty much the same. It's just vice versa. So the price is crossing down the MAs. We get green histogram bars from this zone. And we measure it to, first of all, this level. Then we have further continuation and so on. So the initial part would be comparing it from here to here. Okay? Then we have the pullback. Then we have the next one, which would be from here to here. This is already where we have divergences. Then we have another green bar. And then we have this. So the comparison will be between this and that. Alright, again, histogram to zero and histogram to the extreme of the MAs. Super, super simple. Another example. Not this one, this one. This is where we start. This is where we end. That's my lowest point. Histogram, that's my lowest point. MAs. I measure this versus that. Okay? That's it. Here I'm covering the idea of the horizontal ranges, which I already believe you understand. So basically we're looking for the given color. If we're looking for bearish patterns, we measure from red to red. We don't include the green. If we're looking for bullish pattern, we are measuring from the green to the green. So this is my extreme point, and this is my extreme point right here. This is my extreme point, this is my extreme point right here. And I'm going to measure this distance versus that distance. Okay? That's all. And if we get the given ratio, we start looking on the lower time frames for whatever we're looking for in order to trade it. Trading the delta pattern in two automated steps. So first of all, what we do, we identify the momentum and the volume. This is what the delta pattern is doing for us on the higher time frames. Okay, how we do it is we split into two time frames, guys. And the way I do it personally is 4-hour chart in combination with 15 and 30 minute charts, daily chart in combination with H4 and H1, weekly chart in combination with daily charts, and pretty much that gives you the idea how it works. Okay. Then on the lower time frames, we're looking for entry signals, divergences, and breakouts. I said here two automated steps because all that, if you're using the software, is done for you automatically. All right. Now, in up until now, we covered number one in the beginning. Now let's focus on the next part. So up until now, we were talking about this one, right? Now we're going to talk about the second part of this trading method or strategy. Entries on the lower time frames. Inside the software, we're looking for divergences and breakouts. The software comes equipped with divergence indicator, which is working with the scanner. So all this again is done automatically for you. If you're going to trade it manually, I will show you right now what we're doing. However, guys, if you're going to trade it manually, and I'll show you what we're doing on the lower time frames, what I'm personally doing, but it doesn't matter, you cannot use any other entry method. So once you spot the direction and you have a confirmed direction on the higher time frames, once the pullback starts, it doesn't mean looking for divergences and breakouts is the only way to trade it. There are many people in our community which have amazing results. I even can claim they do much better than myself personally, okay? Using their own trading methods. We have people who do chart patterns, for example, triangles and flags and all these. So they get the direction, and then you're looking for a flag, for example, and then trading this. Right, some people are using Elliott waves based on that. So you get the direction using Elliott waves right here, they trade with that. Whatever works for you and makes you money, this is what you should stick with, okay? What I'm going to show here is just an example of what I'm doing for myself. Next important part is that if you do not understand anything about divergences, do not worry about it, guys. The software comes with the rapid divergence course. It has video, PDFs. Of course, you have myself at your disposal in the Telegram groups. Divergences are covered. You will understand what it's all about if you don't know it, so don't worry about it. All right, entries. The algorithm will pick the divergences automatically for you and send you alerts. And when we talk about alerts, we're talking about mobile alerts, MT4, MT5 alerts, email alerts. Okay? Of course, the recommendation is for you to understand how divergences work in general and don't blindly rely on the software. The software is there to just give you an idea that there is divergence there. Okay? But if you understand more about divergences and you master divergences, then you will be doing much better. Okay? Basically, any single part of any software or strategy, if it's a multi-component strategy, if you understand each of these components independently, you will be doing much better. Okay? We mentioned, for example, triangles coming after delta patterns and trading that as entries. There you go, you have two components here. First component is the delta pattern, second component is triangles. Triangles are completely independent thing. If you master triangles and chart patterns in general, you will be doing much better when you combine these two. This is what I'm trying to say here. Anyway, moving forward. So what are we looking for when it comes to the entries? We're looking for divergence to form between the moving averages of the MACD indicator and the price. Aggressive entries, and this is now part of the second version of the software, aggressive entries are based on divergences alone. We're looking for some extra filters which are covered in the additional webinars of the Delta, all right? But that gives you an idea what I'm doing. Then we have the conservative entries, which are basically divergences plus breakout of the middle point of that divergence. So we add one extra layer of confirmation before we pull the trigger for the conservative ones. And that probably sounds confusing, so let's jump to the images here. This is an example of conservative entry. As we said, so first of all, you have bearish delta pattern. Okay, you know how to spot it already. Then this is your pullback. And during the pullback, What we're looking for is divergence between the MAs. Okay. This is our divergence. And then we want to see the middle point of this divergence broken. And this is where we get the breakout. So this is where we're starting to look for the sells. Simple, isn't it? Next, if we're looking for aggressive entries, using the same example, our entry will be based on the divergence alone. So basically, we have the push down on the higher time frame. This is the lower time frame, the divergence is happening, and we start looking for divergences that we're going to attack. Again, we are applying some simple filters, all discovered in the video. All right, we don't attack any single divergence, but this is generally the idea. We're going to confirm with levels, and I'm going through all these levels and how you can improve the accuracy of divergence entries. But in general, that's the idea. One is aggressive with the divergence, the other one is once we get the middle point broken. Another example, which comes from the other direction, this time we have bullish move on the higher time frame, then the price starts correcting itself, and this is where we drop to the lower time frame. So if this is, let's say, 4-hour chart, this is your 15 minute chart right here, you get the divergence on the MAs, and for conservative entry you want to see the middle point of this divergence broken. If you're looking, on the other hand, for aggressive entries, you will be looking at this bar right here once the divergence is completed, and then you're attacking aggressively at the end of the divergence. So that pretty much summarizes how the software works, guys. Higher time frame, we are looking for these ratios to form. We drop to the lower time frames once we get the direction. And this is where we can start looking for chart patterns, for divergences, for breakouts, or whatever you feel comfortable with in order to, you know, join the ongoing momentum. That's all. If you have any questions up until this part, please leave your comment below, all right? And it will be answered. Alright, now let's talk about the components of the software, and now you will understand what the software does for you and what is the difference between trading with the software and trading it manually. The software is composed of basically two things. The first thing is the scanner, and the second thing is the trading template or the dashboard. And to make things a bit more visual, this is what you're getting in component number one. This is your scanner. What the scanner does, guys, is basically a simple table which is showing you on the left hand side the time frame combinations. So right here, let's say we have the 4-hour chart plus the 15 minute chart, 4-hour chart, 30 minute chart, and so on and so forth. On the other hand, on the top, we have the assets which we're scanning. We can work with pretty much any asset we would like, cryptos, indices, you know, oils, forex, oils, commodities, sorry. And then wherever the two points meet, you get these arrows. Now in version 2, we introduced the aggressive entries. That means we now have 3 arrows, not just 2. And basically the software is scanning for the different states of the market on the given symbol for the given time frame. And as you can see, you can do that manually. Again, I encourage you to go ahead and do it manually. You know how to spot the delta patterns, you know how to spot conservative and aggressive entries. What the software does is it just saves you a bit time, because this is, I don't know how many, four time frames. Then you have the lower time frames. You know, it's just time consuming. The pattern is extremely simple, but it could be time consuming. So this is what the software is doing for you, right? It just scans for these conditions. And now to the arrows, what you saw on the previous slide. When you have one arrow alone and the other two are grayed out, it means you only have delta pattern on the higher time frame. You don't have on the lower time frames divergence, you don't have breakout of this divergence. Then you have the aggressive one. So if you have aggressive, which is two arrows, that means delta pattern on the higher time frame. That means the price moved and formed bearish divergence in this case, right? And if we have the conservative, which is three arrows, that means the divergence was created, then the price started moving lower, and the middle point of that divergence was also broken. So you're going to receive conservative alert right here at that very moment. I'm going to show you examples in a bit, so don't worry about it. Same thing about conservative, just vice versa, right? Like this, one arrow, two arrows, three arrows right here at the breakout. That's about the scanner. Pretty simple, very functional, alerts, different settings there. I didn't put it on purpose because I just want you to get a simple idea of what's happening with the scanner. The trading dashboard, this is how it looks. We've introduced new filters, the delta pattern and all these things. I will cover it also a bit later, but in terms of visuals, this is what you get, guys. All right, on the very top you have the trade management, which is giving you the basic information about your trades, the profit, the loss, the risk reward ratios. You can open market order, you can set pending orders, and by clicking this button, for example, you're just going to get three lines on the chart, okay? And you're just moving the stop loss, the take profit, the entry levels, and you just click set pending, right? You don't work with numbers, you don't do anything. You just set your risk. Let's say you want to risk 1% or $100 per trade. You set that in the settings, click set pending, move the three lines wherever you wish on the chart, right? And boom, you have your entry there. Same for sell entry, it's just that the market price will be used. So this is how it looks. Then we have the filters, then we have the delta pattern. So one of the most important features in the second part of the software is this quality filter, guys. We did put a lot of work and thought into that because from the feedback we got in the first version, people were not able, or at least they had issues identifying the good delta patterns. So we finally came up with a solution how to manage to filter that. The range was present in the first version, but it's also pretty decent filter that we have there. One other new thing here is the delta pattern dashboard, which now shows you once you click on the symbol and the chart is opened, then you can see for the given specific chart if you have any other delta patterns on the other time frames, which is useful because if you have different momentums on the different time frames, you want to, you know, be aware of that and just make sure you're not going against some major move which is happening on the higher time frame, for example. So again, really useful stuff. The dot is also very visual thing, which many people gave us the advice there to go ahead and apply something like that. And of course, the alpha pattern, as we know it from version 1, the visuals are slightly different here, but in general, it does the same thing. So, some of the main features, guys, I mean, this is probably too much text. You can also see these things on the website with much more explanation there, but I will try to cover the bases. So you're getting alerts again by text, email, MT4, pretty much we're covering all the bases. You will get educational videos, plenty of them. We have a lot of educational materials from the first version of the software. This is still there, that still applies, all right? There are new webinars coming for version 2. Again, based on the aggressive entries and some other things. So definitely plenty of materials for you to go ahead and enjoy and learn new things, which by the way are not going to help you just with Delta and this one. It will help you in general with your trading, because I'm covering there many interesting and default situations. You're getting a manual. Well, that's, I guess, needless to be said. The manual covers everything in detail. So basically whatever we're covering here, and that all that information is covered in the manual, so you can print it and, you know, have it at your disposal at any given time. The rapid divergence course, again, as I said, this is remaining in version 2 as a bonus feature. It's, I believe, pretty decent. I mean, at least based on the feedback, I'm not able to judge because I understand divergences. The question is if the people who are looking at it and trying to understand divergences, if they do get it. And so far, the feedback was good, so I'm pretty happy with that. I didn't change it, I didn't touch it, you know, if it ain't broken, don't fix it, right? So you will get that as well. It comes with video and a PDF book. Now, as I said, the new feature here is the aggressive and conservative entries, which I covered back in the first version of the software. We only had conservative setups. Now we introduce the aggressive ones, which is superb, because now you can enjoy from more than twice more entries. Okay, because sometimes after the move, you will get first divergence, move, second divergence, move, until the actual breakout is happening. So why not enjoy all these pushes here, right? We have two shortcut buttons, absolutely amazing. Now, this is not a new functionality, guys, but it's pretty useful stuff. And I'm not going to cover all these things versus the button, because we are going to cover it in details now. Before that, I would just like to show you a simple comparison table between what you can do manually with Delta 1 and Delta 2. Okay, so when it comes to manual trading, you will be doing more or less the basics here. You find yourself a pattern and you go ahead and trade it conservatively or aggressively. This is more than enough, especially if you have some previous knowledge on divergences and price action. It's absolutely more than enough for you to start making money and using it, at least testing it, guys. I'm serious about that. As I told you in the beginning, I've been doing it for approximately 2 years. It's doable. Okay? Then when it comes to the Delta 1, the first version of the software, as you can see, we didn't have the aggressive entries introduced. We did cover many of the other bases here. Okay, up to here, so manuals, the webinars, the trade manager and all that was covered. Now in version 2, you will see many core features here that were introduced. So basically you can do all of that, which we're seeing right here, plus the new things. So what's new? For example, we have the multi-trade manager. What does that mean? That means if you have 3 trades opened based on Delta, you can close all the charts and you can leave only the scanner running, which is going to take care of these 3 trades. It will move the stop losses, it will take first target, it will take second target, it will manage the trade instead of you. Plus, you're saving CPU and RAM, you know, the consumption from the computer. If you're doing other things there, you're going to lower all these resources and whatever the MT4 is using, because you can have less charts, and it's actually pretty cool. We have introduced the trade journal. Many people were underestimating the trade journal, and for some reason they just don't stick with this thing long enough to see whether they're realizing any progress with their trading or not. So we've decided to create something that will finally take care of this issue, and now we have the trade journal. So basically, once you open a trade, you will get two screenshots of exits and entries. So you can see precisely where the price was during the entry, because when we go back and when we look at it, it's a bit confusing, guys. I mean, you see what happened afterwards, right? And then you say, yeah, I should have done this, I should have done that. But when you remove the price and you actually see what you are looking at that given moment, it's much better for you to find yourself where are your mistakes, if you have any mistakes, and usually you do have mistakes, and how to fix them, how to improve your trading. So this is super, super powerful feature there. If you get the software, I strongly, strongly advise you to use the trade journal. Okay? I've seen it many times. People who are collecting their trades in Excel sheet or whatever, they did tremendous progress, guys, within weeks, let's say months, okay? Even if it's months, depending on your trading style, long-term, short-term. Could be between weeks and months. But you cannot pinpoint an issue if you're not following the progress, okay? You gotta see, I mean, besides your performance curve, which is going up or down. Why is it going up or down? Well, if it's going up, you probably don't care because you're doing the right thing, right? But if it's going down, why? You cannot expect to do the same thing over and over and over again and get different results. Okay, this is the definition of madness, I believe, by Einstein. So if you're going down, it's not just enough to go ahead and say, okay, the strategy doesn't work, or this doesn't work, or I need to change my trading style or whatever. You need to find the problem. If you find the problem, then you can say, I need to change this or that. Unless you have a definition of a problem, you cannot fix it. And usually what happens is people get a new strategy, free, paid, it doesn't matter. And there is a loop, a very, very nasty loop. You get a new strategy, you take 3, 5, 10 trades, trading it for a few weeks or a few days, and the moment you see the capital dropping, okay, this doesn't work, I move on to the next one. And with the next one, you do the same. And in reality, you need to dedicate time for anything. I mean, any given strategy that you're going to use, whatever it is, again, paid or free, you need to give it enough time to understand how this thing works. That could be days, that could be months. If you're trading daily chart, you cannot expect to have enough experience with that in 1 week, right? So it's a very doomed spiral or loop, which usually doesn't end up well. If you have enough trades, if you have enough experience with the given strategy, let's say 100 or 200 trades, and you're measuring your progress, you're following the rules, okay, I followed the rules, 50 trades, 60 trades, 70 trades, and it's still not providing me with the results, even though I'm following the rules, okay, it's the strategy. Don't use it. And of course, do that on a demo account, there is no need to lose money. But if you're just testing it with 5 trades and then you decide this doesn't work, how can that be statistically correct, right? So extremely important thing here about the trade journal, even though some people say, trade journal, whatever, not that important. That thing could be the difference between becoming successful or not becoming successful. One thing I missed here to mention, guys, actually two things, is that in version 2, we now have MT5, which is super interesting, because basically all of them are not going to support, they are not supporting MT4 anymore. So if you're using MT4 and your broker doesn't support Sorry, if you're using MT5 and you don't have support for MT4, don't worry about it. The software has it covered as well. Trade journal, we have the news on the chart, the auto fibo, the delta quality filter. I mean, this comparison table you can look for yourself. I would like to go ahead and show you all this new stuff right now with some examples. So aggressive entries, guys, as I said in the beginning, we did introduce aggressive entries now with version 2. So in version 1, the only way to enter based on the software, of course, and the alerts was once we broke here. That was the divergence, that was the breakout. This is where we got the alert. Now we have second type of alert, which is once the price is completing here the divergence, we're going to get another alert. And this is super powerful because, as I said many times, after the divergence, we're going to get this, and then the price will drop. And then we're going to get this, and then the price will drop. So why not enjoy these moves? That's one. Second of all, if this is going to be the final breakout already and the price is continuing higher, imagine what kind of improvement you're going to get, because for conservative entries you will be entering here with, let's say, this kind of stop loss. Or with aggressive entries, you will be entering somewhere lower, especially when you have situations like this one. Let's say this is your conservative entry signal and this is the breakout zone. So look at the risk reward ratio before even a conservative setup is there. All right, so you're going to enjoy from this move. You can be cashing out already here, first part, and then the second part could be running for the final target of this one. So the risk reward ratio becomes insane. Furthermore, another benefit, let's say you're attacking aggressively, you cash out first part here or here, wherever it is, right? Depending on your rules. And then you get entry and stop loss. So what happens now? This, we look at it as one complete setup. At least I do look at it as one full setup, split into two parts. So the first one is giving me money. Second one, I'm losing money. And at the end of the day, I will be ending up with some small percentage. Let's say if initially I'm risking 1% and this one provided me with 0.8% profit, okay, then instead of losing 1 full percent, I will end up with 0.2, right? So splitting the entries between the two, really beneficial. And I think many of you guys are going to enjoy it. All right. Next, as we said, we have MT5 support added because of meta quotes, right? MT5 platform was introduced in 2010, but for some reason, most people, refuse to switch to MT5. And in my opinion, personally, the reason for refusing is because many of the codes we had for MT4 would not work on MT5. And this is really stupid. I'm not sure why they couldn't make some sort of bridge or provide some kind of service which will convert MT4 to MT5, but they didn't. And that's why many people, I mean, imagine, guys, you invested hundreds of dollars or thousands in MT4 software, and then suddenly they tell you, okay, you cannot use it anymore, you gotta switch to MT5. And then you go back to the coders, and the coders are charging you again, because, I mean, I can understand them, it's completely new job, right? You need to rewrite the whole code, or at least part of it, but it's still a job. So it's kind of lose-lose situation for everyone. Anyway, they simply refuse to support MT4 anymore. New brokers are not allowed to offer MT4 anymore. So basically, one way or another, we're going to switch to MT5 eventually. And that's why we've decided to, just make a version for both platforms at that stage, so we don't deal with any issues later on. Multi-language support, so if you're not an English speaker and you have issues with English, you have the ability to use French, German or Spanish, and just giving you an idea how the software looks. Now, very important note here, the webinars that you're going to look at, the manual and basically all the supportive materials are not translated, guys, unfortunately, at least on that stage. What's translated is the software. That's all. So you're going to get the scanner, okay, plus the dashboard translated. Of course, all the settings on the inside, this will be translated, alerts and so on and so forth is translated, but these things are not, okay? So yeah, multi-language support is there, and now the Delta quality filter. I'm super proud of this thing. Again, as I said, many traders struggle to find the difference between good and bad patterns, because after all, guys, let's admit it, I mean, any software I've been using, it's not perfect. I still cannot compare anything to the human eye and the way the human brain works. In just 30 seconds, I can analyze 5 time frames, I can include trend lines, I can include highs, lows, divergences, Fibonacci's. In order to code it, all this to be coded in a single piece of software to make it work, it's super hard. Trust me, we've tried many times, and we've tried with not so many things as I mentioned. I mean, just try to go ahead and define trend lines, for example. A simple trend line, go ahead and try to define it. What's the low that needs to be connected to the next low? And you will see how many questions are opened. So sometimes when we see something extremely simple for the human eye, it could be extremely complex in order to be coded. So when I'm saying that I'm proud of this thing, the quality, just a single thing that shows A and B, I really am, guys, and I think we did a pretty decent job. Feedback is to be yet heard from the traders, because this is what matters at the end of the day. It doesn't matter what I think. It's important that it is helpful, but we're still at a very young stage at the moment, so let's see what the community thinks about it once they have a bit of experience. So this thing works, and again, it's basically looking at the Delta pattern on the higher time frame. It will give you an indication whether you should be paying more attention to that or not. The advice here is, just because you see quality A, don't blindly trust that this is the best setup in the world. Go ahead and check out what's happening on the higher time frame after all. Okay? But it's a major improvement. This is an example of what quality A, and now you're going to see quality B. So as you can see here, we have a strong bearish momentum, the divergences started appearing, pullback started appearing, and then we got the push up. And this is where we see, this is daily chart of Eurofranc, where the daily pattern is saying it's up, and that this is currently quality A. This is what we're looking for. Beautiful momentum coming with the price, breaking the previous highs. You know, it clearly shows us that this is bullish momentum right here. Okay. Then on the other hand, let me show you another example where we have quality B this time. And this is Euro Pound daily chart, if I'm not wrong. Here, look how different the situation is. This is your Delta pattern. Okay, actually here. But this entire thing is moving up, and it's coming to a place where we have divergence. Okay? Oh man, I wanted to sneeze, sorry guys. So basically the Delta pattern is already inside a divergence place. We had huge push up, V pattern to the downside, and then this comes. It's not new high. We're kind of stuck in between this previous move. Yes, technically speaking, we have the ratios there. The momentum is there, and this thing, it moved higher after all, I think, in the previous days. Okay? So it did work. I'm not saying it's not going to work if it's quality B, but when you compare it to the previous slide and the previous move, I think you will find the difference. This is absolutely different situation than that one. Okay? So again, the quality filter, absolutely amazing, amazing job there. One more example of this thing. So quality A, the price is pushing higher, no divergences. I mean, you can see it's clear, nice trend to the upside. We're looking for buys here. Okay. Next, here it is, the automatic trading journal that we've been talking about, guys. And this is basically how it looks. You're going to take your entries, all right? And this is an actual screenshot, all right? This one and that one. You're taking the entries and this is what you're going to see. So let's say this is your entry right here and you're looking at whatever you were looking at during the time of the entry. Nothing after that. So now you can really analyze, was that good one or was that a bad one? Did I miss anything on the chart? Was there strong support before that? Was there strong trend line before that? The Fibo level that I was looking for is not there, you know? All these things much easier to analyze when you don't see the future price, and much more realistic feedback for yourself. And then you have the exit screenshot, which is telling you what happened with the given trade. I think you get the point, so no need to spend more time on that. Next interesting part is the news on the chart. It will be placed on the top right corner of your chart. I really hope it doesn't take too much time. Of course, that could be hidden. You can hide it, it's not a problem. It comes with a few standard options. We can change the color based on the type of news. So you have high, medium and low pack, low impact news, and all this could be changed. Like here we have low impact and medium impact, for example, the yellow and the white. You can filter the news by current symbol only or all of them, all news. And we can play with the time adjustment. Now this is a very technical thing. So basically if the automatic setup doesn't work here, you can push these lines left to right in order to fit wherever it is supposed to fit. And if it doesn't work for some reason, we have the manual option there as well. So having the news on the chart, it's useful, especially if you're doing, you know, let's say intraday trade right here for some reason, and you're scalping and you know there is high impact news, spread will be widening, you know, the price might be jumping up or down. Many times, me including, sometimes I miss the news, so we thought it could be a very interesting addition. Then we have the auto fibos. The auto fibos are very important. If you know me from before, guys, you know how much I rely on levels just because they work. I mean, this is the ABC of trading, the supply demand zones, right? You have levels where the price is simply going to bounce. And here we have a level. And here we have the 38.2 fibo. Surprise, surprise. So now I know I have a bullish pattern. The price is jumping, not jumping, pushing lower, going to the 38.2 retrace, and I'm looking for buys right here. And even though the price didn't go to the top, this is more than enough for me on the lower time frames if I have the setup to make some money. And then we go again to this place, and then we're pushing once again. And again, 38.2 is here and the divergence is here, so why not enjoy? I understand that levels are extremely simple, but again, for some reason, some people are not able to do it. I don't know why, maybe they need to practice more. But having these fibos on the chart, again, you can do it manually, guys. You see, just drop the fibo between the low and the high of your delta pattern and you got it. It's not something wow, right? It just helps us and saves us a bit more time. That's it. But I like this feature very much. Levels are important. Now, as we said, the multi-trade supervisor or manager, as I explained to you, let's say you have a few trades here, you can close all these charts and then the scanner will manage them. That's it. I put here three major benefits by which the supervisor or the manager is giving us. We're saving computer resource, we're keeping our trading chart and the environment cleaner, because sometimes you get yourself stuck in 20-25 charts and you just simply get lost there. And one more thing which is a psychological benefit and probably the most important one is you don't get tempted to go ahead and mess with your trade. Because too many times people are just buying and cutting their profits too early while letting losers run, and they don't apply any stops to that. So by not looking at the chart and knowing that the manager is going to take care of that, you actually eliminate this problem here. Okay, so it's strong one. I like it. And this is actually a realistic core improvement, guys, because if you're trading manually, you probably found yourself, especially if you're trading on the slightly intraday or higher time frames, mid-higher time frames, you open a trade, and if you don't have the right tools to trail the stop loss, collect target one, all that could be the difference between winning and losing in the long run. And again, if you trade it manually, you will know what I'm talking about. Because sometimes you just go to sleep or go to work or go do something else, and the move happens or divergence comes against and you're not there to manage it, right? Or the price comes 3 pips away from your entry, and if you're not there to cash it out or at least to move the stop loss to break even, instead of a winner, you get a loser. So the manager, it's very powerful stuff. The inner Delta dashboard is basically a micro scanner which is working precisely on the given asset. Again, the scanner is giving you the overview of all the assets you're following according to your wishes, while the Delta pattern inner dashboard here is giving you the Delta patterns on all time frames for that single instrument. So if this is your dollar, this is all about your dollar. 4 hour bullish, daily bullish, monthly bearish. And this is important, guys, because if you have different, like in this case, we have daily and weekly in different directions. This is where you want to see, okay, at what stage, where does the weekly chart stand? Are we currently in the pullback or is it going towards invalidation? Do we have divergences? Do we not have divergences? Is the weekly pattern good or bad? Quality A or quality B? And you wanna basically look at the full picture when you have different Delta patterns. Okay? Because if the weekly bearish Delta pattern is not that strong and you conclude that this is not good and it's not interfering with your daily bullish direction, then you're good to go and trade the daily. But if this is super strong and daily just finished the divergence, right, and you're expecting this thing to push strong to the downside because of the higher time frame direction, and daily at the same time is giving you bullish Delta pattern right here, well, clearly you want to skip the daily and enjoy the weekly alone, right? On the other hand, weekly is doing something like this and now start pushing higher. There is still no divergence, there is nothing like that. So what you expect is for this thing to push much higher before the sell setup is ready. In that case, we go ahead and take the daily chart and enjoy on the 1 hour and 4 hour chart these pullback moves which are happening on the weekly chart. So these two arrows and this small inner window here could be extremely important. Why? Because in version 1 once you clicked, you didn't get this info. And if you forgot to check what's happening on the scanner on this specific pair for the given time frames, you could be missing this part. You start analyzing, you get lost on the daily chart and the 1 hour chart setup, and then you miss that you have something against the weekly chart. So I think this small table here, super important. Another thing which we were missing in version one, now this is more visual stuff, but it was annoying, is to not be able to understand which time frame combinations are you working with. Because if I'm currently sitting on M15 as my current time frame, I'm working with the 4 hour chart delta pattern, right? So now this dot is showing me exactly that. In this case, the daily chart is working with H4 and H1. So if I see the dot here, it means the current time frame is either H1 or H4. Okay? And the dot means we're working with the daily bullish pattern. So I don't get lost in between the differences here, in between the different time frames. If the dot is sitting on the 4 hour chart, then I know I'm working with M15 or M30 in combo with H4, right? So it's a very small thing, but I think visually it helps a lot to quickly identify what's happening, what time frames, you know. All right, the next thing we have is the flag in the scanner. What the flag is basically, again, another dot which will appear in the given cell of the given time frame plus trading asset. So let's say this is weekly chart for QEM. It means that we have a conservative bullish setup and we have an order there. That could be pending order, that could be market order, which is already running trade. But you have it, and once you look at the scanner, you can see where and what is happening. Why is this important? Well, first of all, visually you can see where you've been involved already. But it really helps us with the exposure, guys, and the overexposure. Why? Because if for some reason you decide to trade all these three QEs, okay, you will understand from the scanner that you already have exposure on QEN, exposure on QE dollar, and exposure on I don't know what else. So having more than two trades on the same currency usually means overexposure unless you're controlling the risk. What I mean is, if I usually trade 1% and I get two bullish setups on this one and that one, usually I'm going to split my risk to this 0.5 and 0.5 for each of those two. If I'm going to trade three setups, then I'm going to split it to 0.3 per each. This way, whatever happens, I'm going to be risking approximately 1% if all three of them lose. Why I'm saying that? Because usually when you have same currency related in different pairs, you have correlations that could be negative, that could be positive correlation, but usually you have correlations and you pretty much get the same setups. Same with the pounds, pound, cut, pound, kiwi, pound, Aussie. It's not 100%, but it's something for us to pay attention to. So eliminating the risk of overexposure by looking at this little guy here, I think it's good. It's good feature to have. Next we have the delta pattern levels on the chart. Again, this is not something crucial, but it was missing in the first version. So I really thank everyone who send us the feedback about this to be added. We did add it. So now let's say this is your 4 hour chart. Okay, as you can see, the dot is right here, which means we're working with H4 or H1 combined with the daily chart, and daily is bullish. And what's my bullish delta pattern? And where is it? It's right here. This is my bullish delta top and delta bottom. I have the delta levels, and It's much clearer now. It's much clearer. Again, nothing critical or major. We lived with that for approximately 2 years, a year and a half. But it's a good addition, at least in my point of view. Then we have the two shortcut buttons, which you can see right here, guys. Just a full view. They're barely noticeable, very small, tiny little buttons, but they do a lot. Again, as I said, I usually find myself in MT4 having too many charts open. Trading strategy one, strategy two, this trade, that trade, following this, you know, at some point you lose it. So we've decided to add the first button right here, which once clicked, if you're sitting on a Delta dashboard, if you click on this thing, you will be taken back to the scanner. Okay? Again, nothing critical or major, but it's really helpful, especially if you find yourself in a situation where you have multiple charts open and you always look, where is my scanner, where is this template, where is that template. The second one is the reset button, which is basically resetting the template. So let's say, let me just go back to the previous slide for a second. Let's say you were drawing here some lines, okay, you were drawing here some levels and doing whatever else, drawings, analysis. Instead of going and selecting each of these components independently, what you do is, boom, a reset template, and once you click that, you reset the template to the default one, and all other objects which you had on the chart added there additionally manually by the trader will be removed. Simple feature, but valuable for those who like to draw and put too many things on the chart. Alright, next I would like to show you a few very quick examples, guys, so you can get an actual idea of what and how is happening with the software. So once you get the setup, this is your daily chart, this is the 1 hour chart. The setup is here. First divergence, this one would be failing. Second divergence, winning. Then we have breakout for conservative entry. So basically we are looking at the conservative entry. You can see the news, you can see the daily Fibonacci retracement levels and all that. Okay, so kind of looking at this thing in action. One more example, this time to the downside. Here we have the range, which is not that good, which means usually we want to be looking for pullbacks. This is what the range filter is doing for us, right? It's checking this range. So we have bearish pattern from the 4 hour chart. And then once we got the breakout, the software is telling us, all right, but this range is too wide, because if you start protecting here, the stop loss will be, the take profit will be here. Better wait for pullbacks, right? This is what this thing is suggesting. Again, it's just a suggestion. No one is saying you have to do based on the filters. Quality, not so good, in my opinion. That's because we were trading in a range here. But this is basically how this thing looks, all right? And again, you can see the divergence on the top, beautiful candle pattern, engulfing happening, bouncing from the 38.2, and it's all there. So if you open the chart, again, we can do all this analysis manually, guys. You can do this 100% free manually with all the tools you have currently. We are not reinventing the wheel besides this pattern, which is, in my opinion, awesome. Okay, the Delta pattern. Anything else, you can draw the Fibos yourself, you can find the divergence yourself, you can wait for the breakout, confirm here with the levels and all that, and trade it. Okay, again, I encourage you to do that manually. You will learn a lot, and it will help you a lot if you decide to get the software. Okay. One more example. Here we have, what do we have? 4 hour chart, bearish. We're currently on the 15 minute chart. This is the push lower we're looking for. for sales, right? Because of this, we got the two waves up, the price is bouncing between the 38 and 50 zone. Levels, I would say here in terms of manual levels, and we can extend it, and that kind of fits with the 38.2. The divergence was recognized on the MAs, and we are looking for sales. Okay, so let me see, do we have one more? Yeah, this is Aussie, and this time we have bullish setup. 1 hour chart in combination with the daily 4 hour chart is also supportive, and we're looking for the buys. We got here the divergence, push down, pull back, push down. We create the ABC. Divergence, as I said, is in place. I don't like that it's not close to any of the Fibos, but what we do see here is this zone right here being a strong level. And I'll mark also right here, this one. So if we extend it, we can see we're somewhere in between this and that level, right? The price stopped here, so clearly we can expect to find some support because we broke above, we're pushing lower, we're finding the divergence, delta pattern confirming from two time frames, okay? A level is in place. At least the short-term trade has good chance to succeed, in my opinion. So this is basically how the software looks, guys. And that actually concludes this video. The official website is fxdelta.net, guys. Again, you get access to the Telegram group, so if you decide to go ahead and join our community, make sure to join us in the Telegram groups as well. Looking forward to meet new people. If you have any technical issues or any other questions, whatever it is, drop us a line and the support team will be able to help you. And if you have Telegram and you have my contact, you can contact me directly, and I'll do my best to support you with whatever issue you might be having. So I guess that's it. Thanks everyone for your time, guys, and wishing you a lovely day.